human sacrifice has been propagated to the present day through the mystery religions. There are groups and institutions today which have preserved and continue to promote the teachings and practices of the ancient mystery religions. Unfortunately, there are many such organizations and secret societies that still exist today. They continue to teach the core doctrines and practices of the ancient mystery religions. The Dionysianic mysteries were observed in a number of different places. The ceremonies, which were orgiastic, required drinking of sacred wine, eating of the raw flesh of a sacrificed animal, and drinking the blood of the animal. The ultimate purpose of the cult's ritual was an assurance of immortality. The origins go back to ancient Babylon. The scripture says that the Babylonian mysteries will form the backbone of apostate religion during the last days. The link between human sacrifice and the mystery religions can be established beyond a shadow of a doubt. The Dictionary of Satanism by Wade Baskin describes the rite of Dionysus. They sound similar to the stories that are told by present-day satanic cult survivors. Dionysus. In classical mythology, the god of wine and fertility. His cult was widespread in Thrace, where the Thracian women were particularly dedicated to his orgiastic rites. The women, maenads, in their ecstatic frenzy, abandoned their homes, roamed the fields and hillsides, dancing, swinging their flaming torches. In their passion, they caught and tore apart animals, sometimes even children, and devoured the flesh, thus acquiring communion with the divinity. Revelation chapter 17 verses 4 through 5 declare, "The woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet, and adorned with gold and precious stones and pearls, having in her hand a golden cup full of abominations and the filthiness of her fornication. And on her forehead a name was written, Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and of the abominations of the earth." The Babylonian mystery religion was started by Nimrod and his wife Semiramis. According to Flavius Josephus, a Jewish historian who lived during the time of Jesus, Nimrod was the builder of the Tower of Babel and was the first man that Satan tried to use to set up a new world order. Nimrod was apparently killed because of his open and public displays of wickedness. Herein lies the real reason for the establishment of the secret mystery religion. It was not created out of any desire to spread the real truth about God, but only to protect themselves from public outcry and retribution because of the wicked acts that they were committing. Reverend Alexander Hillsop's book, The Two Babylons, explains that although Babylonian religion was originally practiced in the open, it became necessary to conceal it. Hillsop writes, "It seems to have been now only when the dead hero was to be deified that the secret mysteries were set up. The previous form of apostasy during the life of Nimrod appears to have been open and public. Now it was evidently felt that publicity was out of the question." Jeremiah chapter 19 verses 3 through 5 reveals that the judgment of God will fall upon any nation which allows child sacrifice. "And say, Hear ye the word of the Lord, O kings of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel. Behold, I will bring evil upon this place, the which whosoever heareth, his ears shall tingle. Because they have forsaken me, and have estranged this place, and have burned incense in it unto other gods, whom neither they nor their fathers have known, nor the kings of Judah, and have filled this place with the blood of innocents." Paul wrote, "Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion hath light with darkness? And what concord hath Christ with Belial? Or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel? And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God, as God hath said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Wherefore come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. There is a promise contained in this scripture. If you will come out from among them and stop touching the unclean thing, then Jesus is willing to receive you. God is willing to accept you into his family, but there can be no compromise with this ungodly system.